What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you guys how to animate a logo. In this video, I'm going to show you how to bring a brand logo to life in a simple and professional style. This video will also get us a step closer to making animations like this, this, and this as well.
That's good.
Alright guys, so let's dive in. I already got a few things loaded into the project. Right now I've got a white color mat, our vignette transparent video to create that like nice emphasis, and our logo. So let's go ahead and create a sequence first, because that's how we can add things in, make some magic happen. Let's call this Animating Logo. That'll do. Drag that down here. Okay, so now the first thing we're going to add is the white color mat. And now let's zoom in. I'm going to press the slash above enter. So I got the white color mat here. We're not really going to be messing with audio, so I'm going to make these tracks big. Okay, and then now let's go with the vignette. So let's throw the vignette on there. Now this is just a transparent video. There's no vignette on it, so we're going to create the vignette effect. So let's go ahead and type in... ellipse, circle, sorry about that, and we're going to create an ellipse in the effect controls. Okay, so let's go ahead and make sure that we can see it, so let's make the circle black. Okay, here's the radius. You can mess around with the radius to create the vignette. Let's kind of, I think we're going to be aiming around like that realm, but we're going to feather out the edges, so... let's see, feather outer edge. Okay, so we'll go ahead and do that. We'll just really max out that feather so that black goes away. There we go. We already got a nice vignette effect. Cool. So vignette's done. Now let's go ahead and add in our logo and get animating. Okay, so here's our logo. It's kind of big, so I'm going to kind of scale it to where I want it to end up. So I think I want it to end up like right there, because that like takes up the full screen and it's really popping out, especially with the vignette. So now let's get into animating. So we want to make it go from small to big. So we're gonna have it kind of do like a slow zoom effect. Let's see what we got here. Okay, so to animate anything really in Premiere, they all have these little stopwatches. And when you hover over them, it says toggle animation. So when you click on that, it allows you to start adding keyframes to make things, and you can set each keyframe to have different values, whether it's under position or scale, and it'll transition to that value over time, and it'll give you an animation. So to start, we're going to, let's go all the way to the end. So all the way to the end, let's hit the little keyframe button. So it creates a keyframe there at the size that we wanted. So that's where I wanted it to end, right? So at the beginning, I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. So let's have it start roughly around there. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so because I adjusted the scale at wherever the playhead was, it automatically creates a keyframe when I start adjusting the scale. So now let's see how it looks. Cool, we got a nice... slow zoom into the logo. All right, so now let's make it even better looking. let's make the animation a little smoother looking, and it really helps. It really makes the animation look less robotic. So to do that, we're going to use ease in and ease out. So all I did was right click there to right click on the keyframe to select all these different options. And now the ones we want to focus on are ease in and ease out. So with ease in and ease out, it's basically like when you set it to ease out, it'll slowly, gradually start the animation like at a slower speed, and then it'll gradually get faster. So that's what ease out does. So it's like that. And then ease in is the opposite. So it goes from fast to slow. So it's like, and then it slows down. So what you want to do when you're going gradually over time, the effect that we kind of want to create is where the logo like it starts slow, and then it gets to normal speed, and then it slows back down nice and gradually. So let's first ease out so that we can start slow. And then with the other keyframe, let's ease in. Okay, so now that I set that, let's see what the animation looks like. There we go. So you can tell it's a little faster, and then it slows down gradually at the end. See that again? Gradual startup and gradual ending. There we go. So that's actually pretty simple. Now when it comes to doing all of the other examples that I showed you guys, those require a lot more work. Not all of them, some of them just a few simple like techniques. For the Club Pilates one with like the spinning logo. Basically it's all about keyframing rotation. So if I just click the rotation at zero, or here I'll add another keyframe, that's that keyframe button as well. So let's start like, let's do it like that. So because I just adjusted it a little bit and I put that keyframe there, yeah, it does a little rotation. Let's go ahead and put an ease in on that, ease out. Yeah, it's pretty smooth. We can have it snap in, give that kind of like effect. Yeah, just like that. By taking off the ease, and yeah, you can really just play around with all of the different values, whether it's position, scale, or rotation, and start animating with keyframes just like that. And now what we've done with this effect is we've created a good end screen that's more engaging than just like a flat logo that just kind of shows up. So this is definitely where you should start if you're trying to create a video that looks more polished and professional. Thanks guys for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.